At least 8 people have been killed when they were run over at a bus stop near a migrant shelter in Texas. Police are investigating whether the crash was deliberate and whether the driver was targeting immigrants.
At this bus stop in Brownsville, migrants were waiting for their chance at a new life. For many, that chance never came. This footage capturing the sickening moment they were mowed down.
It was really, really sad. People were running to help them. The bodies were all over the place.
Witnesses say the driver appeared to aim straight at the waiting group.
As far as we know, through witnesses saying that he disregarded a red light, and as you can see, we're here in the intersection, he disregarded a red light, went up straight to where the individuals were standing right over there at the bus stop, and he ran over several individuals and rolled over.
Police are hesitant to say the attack was deliberate, their investigation hampered by the driver refusing to cooperate.
It is unknown whether he tried to flee or not, but several of the people here actually detained him and were able to keep him detained until officers got there and actually arrested him.
It's not uncommon to see queues of migrants at the bus stop. They cross the border and are housed at a nearby shelter.
They stay here at the shelter up to 4 days. They have their flights and their bus tickets ready to leave.
Today's tragedy comes as a border policy called Title 42 expires in a matter of days. And when that happens, customs and border officials say there could be as many as 10,000 crossings a day.
The situation at the border is a very serious one.
It's putting pressure on the Biden administration, which is deploying 1,500 troops to help deal with the expected influx.
What we had in 2020 under Donald Trump, success. And Biden and Harris came in and turned success into failure.
But as the political arguing heats up, so too do tensions in the communities most affected. What authorities need to determine now is whether those tensions played any part in this latest horrific incident. Catherine Firkin for 10 News First, New York.